Whether you started with Bolt.new, Lovable.dev, or any other AI development tools, GitHub opens up a world of possibilities for your project. In this video, I'll walk you through deploying your GitHub project to GitHub Pages, all from your browser. GitHub Pages is a powerful and free hosting service that GitHub provides. It lets you publish websites directly from your GitHub repository. It's free for public repositories. GitHub Pages works with HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, making it ideal for static websites. Let me show you how to deploy a public repository to GitHub Pages. For this demonstration, I'll use a finance tracker app that I built with React using Bolt.new. After getting it into GitHub using the Bolt to GitHub extension, I enhanced it further using GitHub Codespaces and GitHub Copilot, which is now available for free. To keep everything in the browser, I'll use GitHub Codespaces to showcase its capabilities. It's free and works just like regular VS Code. You can install extensions like Clang, Rucode, and even Aider without leaving your browser. Let me load the project in GitHub Codespaces. Just go to your GitHub repository, click the green code drop-down button, select the Codespaces tab, and click Create Codespace on Main. Now we'll wait a moment while it loads the project. Before deploying our project, we need to do some initial setup. Don't worry, you'll only need to do this once. After that, every commit to the main branch will automatically deploy to GitHub Pages. Let's start by opening your package JSON file. Right after the name field, add the homepage field to specify your GitHub Pages URL. Use this format. Next, we need to set up the GitHub Actions workflow. In your root directory, create a new directory structure called .github/workflows. This must be the exact directory name, or it won't work. In the workflows directory, create a new file called deploy.yml. You can name it something else if you prefer, as long as it's in the workflows directory. Let me just quickly install the GitHub Actions extension. It won't hurt to do that. I'll sign in to GitHub. I'll now paste in the required code and explain what it does. I won't dive too deep into all GitHub Actions options, just enough to understand how GitHub Pages deployment works. While this might look cryptic at first, you'll notice it follows the same steps we take during development. Setting up our machine, checking out the repository, installing Node, adding dependencies, and building the project. So it's actually quite straightforward. The spaces and indentation are crucial parts of the GitHub Actions workflow syntax. If the formatting isn't exact, the workflow won't run. Let me walk you through the key sections of this workflow file. First, we'll look at how we name and control when our workflow runs. The workflow is named GitHub Pages, which helps us identify it in our GitHub Actions dashboard. The workflow is set up to trigger automatically in two scenarios: whenever we push code to our main branch, and whenever someone creates a pull request. This ensures our deployment process kicks in at the right moments, whether we're directly updating our main code or reviewing changes through pull requests. Let's dive into the jobs section of our workflow file. This section is where we define the actual work that needs to be done during our deployment process. The workflow starts with a job named deploy, which we've configured to run on an Ubuntu virtual machine. Think of this as setting up a fresh computer in the cloud that will handle all our deployment tasks. This virtual environment ensures our deployment process runs consistently, regardless of where or when we trigger it. Now let's explore two critical configuration elements: permissions and concurrency settings. The permissions section is where we specify what access levels our workflow needs. In this case, we grant write access to the repository contents, a crucial setting that allows our workflow to make the necessary changes during deployment. The concurrency setting plays a different but equally important role. It acts as a traffic controller, ensuring that only one deployment process runs at a time for any given workflow and reference. This prevents potential conflicts and ensures smooth, orderly deployments. Let's explore the steps section, starting with our first crucial step, checking out the code. In GitHub Actions, each job is broken down into steps that are executed sequentially. The first step uses the actions checkout before action, which is responsible for copying your repository's code into the Ubuntu virtual machine that GitHub Actions has created for us. Think of it as setting up your workspace. Just like when you clone a repository to your local machine, this step ensures all your project files are available for the subsequent deployment steps. Next, we need to set up Node.js in our virtual environment. This crucial step configures the JavaScript runtime that will power our build process. To do this, we'll use the action setup node action, which is a pre-built GitHub action specifically designed for Node.js configuration. We'll specify version 20 of Node.js. Next comes the install dependencies step. This is where we run npm install to download all the packages our project needs. It's like gathering all the ingredients before cooking. We need everything in place before we can build our project. Let's look at the build project step. This step has a simple name that tells us what it does, and it runs npm run build to create the files we'll put on GitHub pages. Now let's explore the crucial deploy step, the heart of our GitHub Pages deployment process. This step takes all our built files and publishes them to make our site accessible on the web. The deploy step uses the Piece Iris Actions GH Pages action, a powerful tool specifically designed for GitHub Pages deployments. This action streamlines the process by automatically publishing your content to a special GH Pages branch, which GitHub uses to serve your website. I'll demonstrate exactly how this works in just a moment. We've added some important configuration to ensure everything works smoothly. First, we've set up a condition that only allows deployment when changes are pushed to the main branch. This helps prevent accidental deployments from other branches. For authentication, we're using GitHub's built-in token system. The great news is you don't need to set this up yourself. GitHub Actions automatically provides this token for you. Finally, we need to tell GitHub which files to publish. In our case, we're publishing from the /dist directory, though depending on your project setup, this might be /build or /out instead. Finding the right directory is straightforward. Just run your build script from package JSON after installing your dependencies. When you run npm run build, you'll see a dist directory appear with all your production ready files. These are the files that will become your live website. Overall, this workflow automates the deployment process to GitHub Pages by checking out the code, setting up Node.js, installing dependencies, building the project, and deploying the built files to the GH Pages branch. Before deploying, there's one crucial configuration to set up. We need to define the base property in the bitconfig file. While this property defaults to /, it needs modification for GitHub Pages to work correctly. You'll need to either add your project name like this or set it to be relative, as I've done in this example. This setting affects how the built index.html in the dist directory loads JavaScript and CSS files. Let me show you quickly how this works in the index.html file. The index.html file references JavaScript and CSS files from the assets directory. But currently, it uses an absolute path, so this won't work when deployed. We need to run npm run build again for our bitconfig changes to reflect on this file. Now it's time to deploy. Let's commit our changes and push them to GitHub. Head over to GitHub and click on the Actions tab. The first deployment will probably be incomplete. That's to be expected because we need to configure one setting first. Go to Settings, then Pages, and set GH Pages as the deployment branch. After that, GitHub will do the proper deployment. Wait for it to complete, Success! Our site is now live at this URL. Let me test it quickly. Add a new transaction. It works! From now on, every commit to the main branch will automatically trigger a deployment to GitHub Pages. Let's test it out. Let's return to GitHub Codespaces and use GitHub Copilot in agent mode to make some changes. Let me install GitHub Copilot first, since this is a new code space. I'll sign in to GitHub again. Let me close all of these open tabs and clean up our workspace. Now if we take a look at the project, we can delete a transaction very quickly but without a confirmation. So let's add a modal confirmation when deleting a transaction. Let me switch to agent mode in GitHub Copilot. And then I'll add the transaction list component to the context. I'll enter the prompt. Add a modal confirmation when deleting transactions. GitHub Copilot is now generating the needed changes. While it might seem slow at first, once it starts updating the file, the process is quite elegant. I particularly enjoy the UI of the diffs. I always review the changes quickly to ensure they match my expectations. When multiple files need updates, accepting the changes to one file automatically moves you to the next one. It's such a pleasant developer experience. Time to test it out. I'll add a new transaction. Click delete. Perfect. Before pushing our changes, it's good practice to run the build locally in GitHub Codespaces first. This ensures everything will work smoothly in GitHub Actions. Great, no build issues. Now let's commit and push our changes. We'll head over to GitHub to watch GitHub Actions deploy to our GitHub Pages. And voila, our live site is now updated. Let's quickly run another test to see if the modal confirmation is really there. Fantastic, it works. But what if you want to use a custom domain? First, we need to add a CNAME option in our GitHub Actions workflow file like so. Let's commit and push our changes. A CNAME file will be automatically created in the GH Pages branch. And if we open it, we can see our GitHub Pages base URL. Now let's go back to Settings, then Pages, and specify our custom domain. I already have created the CNAME record in my DNS provider. So if you're following along, you will have to go to your DNS provider and create a CNAME record to point your domain or subdomain to your GitHub Pages base URL, like we entered in the GitHub Actions workflow earlier. After setting up the DNS record, we may need to wait a few hours for DNS propagation to complete. But in my case, it's propagated very quickly. After a few seconds, we will also be able to check the Enforce HTTPS checkbox here. We need to reload the page. Now we can view our app in a custom domain or subdomain securely. In this video, we've seen how easy it is to use GitHub's free pages hosting service, all without leaving your browser. For those working with private GitHub repositories, you'll need a GitHub Pro plan, which is quite affordable despite some usage limits. You can find more details in the official GitHub and GitHub Pages documentation. If you're working with different tech stacks, check out the official documentation for Actions GH Pages. To access this, simply open deploy.yml, hold Control, and click the Peace Aries Actions link. Their README file provides comprehensive information about all available options. If you found this tutorial helpful, please like and subscribe for more AI development videos. Thanks for watching, and happy coding!